Hello student, today we are going to learn about the direct memory access. Whenever there is a data transfer process between I/O to memory, one need to have CPU for the controlling action. So whenever there is no direct memory access, one need to access, or I/O device need to access CPU first, and then CPU will give the data or will have the control for the memory. Now with this, we need to have two cycles for the data transfer process, and there is no direct contact between I/O device and memory. In this situation, CPU is involved in the data transfer process, so it will take some time and it will have some extra cycles for the CPU. Now what we have when we use direct memory access? When we have direct memory access, then we have CPU, we have I/O device or I/O controller, we have memory, and we have DMA controller or DMA. Now actually we need to transfer data which is there at I/O controller to the memory, and we need CPU, since CPU have bus access. What does direct memory access do? Direct memory access is in between CPU and your I/O controller for specific period of a time. CPU gives bus control to DMA. So we'll see what exactly the process is. Whenever there is a data towards I/O controller, it will send a signal to DMA controller that we need to have bus access. Now DMA controller will ask CPU whether you can grant buses. Whenever, suppose CPU is doing some work, he will not grant buses to the DMA controller. Suppose CPU is free, that CPU does not need any bus, then CPU will grant bus signal or buses to DMA controller. DMA controller will give an acknowledgement to I/O controller that we can start data transfer process. With this, the actual data transfer process will start between I/O controller and your DMA. These are the three types of buses. One is data bus, then address bus, likewise. Now there will be a data transfer process between I/O controller and memory. Whenever I/O controller sends total data to memory, it will send an end of the process signal to I/O controller and an interrupt signal to CPU. So this is the total process for the data transfer between I/O controller and memory. In this total process, CPU is totally free. Since for specific time period or for this data transfer process, the bus control is given to DMA. So for that specific period, CPU can do other work. So this is very powerful system where we can have data transfer between IO controller and memory. So this is actually DMA transfer process. Thank you, student. Have happy learning.